of the world's two economic superpowers are set to face off this week, and the stakes couldn't be higher, not just for China, but for America as well. And for you, your job, your paycheck. China's President Hu Jintao arrives in Washington today for an official state visit. So will it mark the beginning of stronger ties or perhaps the unraveling of an already strained relationship? Joining us with more this morning, the significance of this state visit, of these two leaders getting together to discuss a variety of issues today.
This is a China Sea. We've had the problems in South Korea, where the North attacked the South two times, and China did big problems. On top of that, the economic issues of currency valuation.
In a nutshell, why is it in the best interest of America to issues like North Korea and also the currency and the trade imbalance?
Yeah. Well, it's absolutely critical for our future. China is the second most we'll expect from China, and Chinese leaders the same. And so our two countries really need to come together and iron out agreements on specific issues, and then we need implementation. I mean, you can have all of the feel-good meetings in the world, but if there aren't specific actions taken by both the United States and China, but more to help the United States to guarantee the kind of open international system that the United States has guaranteed over the last
Frustration about this issue. And did we take our eye off the ball, or did this come as a surprise, the rapid rise of China?
I think it came as a surprise. I mean, everybody knew that China was going to rise. Instant player.
Right.
Now is looking like proliferation with human rights, with all sorts of things.
It is important to
look at growth rates, 10% versus
a lot less. China's certainly putting on the steam. So we'll see how these meetings go, but certainly very critical. Thanks for breaking it down for us.
My pleasure.
Jamie Metzl, great to see you this morning. TJ? Down. 22 minutes past the hour right now. Thanks so much for joining us. We really wanted to get a chance to talk to these two because yesterday this was really the story of the day. College baseball coach donating a kidney to one of his star players. It's something a lot of us might not do or think twice about, but for University Hospital in Atlanta. Great to see both of you this morning. Thanks for being here.
No problem.
Our pleasure.
Kevin, let me start with you. How are you feeling? I mean, because you're here, you're doing interviews. It seems like a remarkable recovery from getting this kidney transplant. A disorder that was causing you problems. You had to undergo dialysis. What is it like to feel now versus how you were feeling as the disease was getting worse? You as well about this. How are you doing physically? I'm going to go for it. I'm going to donate a kidney. I mean, what do they say? What did doctors say? I mean, they probably give you a laundry list of potential risks involved in the in the surgery. Does it make you think twice? Two little ones. You have an 11-year-old son and an 8-year-old daughter. What did your family say when you said that you wanted to go ahead with this and try to do your part to save Kevin's life? Now, Kevin, your family as well. I mean, boy, this is must be such a huge relief for them. Everybody in your family tried to get tested. Nobody turned out to be a match. And what was their reaction when they found out your coach was going to do it? Step up and donate. Change your relationship, down the future. I mean, you owe your life to him. Obviously, you feel almost like he's a son to you for you to do this. And hopefully, Kevin's going to be up and running and be able to play next year. What's that going to be like? Back out there, Kevin, and you got a great prognosis for the future, which is just wonderful news, and we wish you the best of luck. So thanks so much for joining us. Kevin Jordan, Coach Tom Walter, really an inspirational story for anyone that's heard it. Thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
TJ?
All right.